Mordecai never lost his head.
He
always sought the welfare of his people. Mordecai uses his position to seek the prosperity of the people of
Israel.
This is why the Bible says he was great and accepted by his brethren. You see, by being elevated to the highest position in the land, he used his position to bring peace to the people of Israel. He used his position and his influence and authority to make sure that the Israelites, they were protected and they had everything they wanted. Mordecai was a man who promoted the interest of the Israelites.
Mordecai,
beloved, he never disowned the Israelites. And still he remained a devoted religious Jew. In each and every day of his life, he sought the welfare of his people. He will fight for their interest. He will seek to please them.
He
will seek to put them in the right place.
People,
Mordecai, because he was in a position of eminence,
he
never used his position to hurt other people. Imagine how many people are using their position of influence to destroy other people, to hurt other people. Mordecai, he never came against his own countrymen, but he only promoted their interest. Mordecai will always use his position to look after the poor, to protect those who are oppressed. Mordecai was indeed a great man. People of God, as we are the Christians, we must also look after the interests of other people of God. Most of you here in the church, you have been placed in a place of influence.
You have been
elevated to a place or a position of affluence. Are you using your position correctly? The position that you have been given, that position of influence and power, use that position to look after other people. Look after that. Use that position to look after the poor or the sick or the needy. Use your position of influence to pray or intercede for other people. Mordecai, he was a type of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, he was a man who was having a high position. High position in a high place. But Jesus Christ never misused his power. Instead, he used his power to look after the interest of the sinners, to remove you from darkness to the light, to move you from the zero to make you a somebody.
You
see, Mordecai, he was a type of a church. A church which always looks after other people. A church which is concerned about its community. A church which goes where there are people who are hating. A church which will look after the homeless. It's a shame that people were using our position for bed. Many of you, you are people of influence wherever you are. But how are you using your position? Are you using that position that has been given to you for good? Or are you using it to get against other people, to get other people to pay revenge?
Or ulawu lenda ohlela ukuyonikeza khona ukuthi usebenzele ukuthi abanye abantu buyisele uziphindezele.
Some of you, you are in close contact with people of high positions.
Abanye bethu ke sinokuxhumana nabantu abanamandla amadoda
phezulu. You fellowship with the kings of kings.
Ukuthi ke bahlangane naye amadoda namakhosi wamakhosi.
Some of you, you are in contact with the mayors and the councillors.
Abanye bethu sinokuxhumana namameya namakhansela.
Some of you, you know the MEC somewhere, you know the ministers.
Abanye bethu sazo MEC no minister.
How are you using that fellowship that you have with those people? Are you using the fellowship you have with those people of big names to influence your position, to influence your community better?
Ngabe wena lokho ukuxhumana onako ukusebenzisa ukuthi uphakamise na umphakathi wakini?
Are you using your connection to look after other people?
Ngabe usebenzisa lokho ukuxhumana kwakho ukuthi ubhekele abanye abantu na?
Church, the Bible says to him who knows how to do good.
IBhayibheli lithi kuloyo owaziko kwenza okuhle.
And does not do it.
Angakwenzi.
To him is sin.
Kuye kuyisono.
We are sinning while we are in the church.
Senza isono siloku sisebandleni.
Why? Because God has elevated you to a high position.
Ngoba uNkulunkulu kuphakamisile wakubeka endaweni ephezulu.
But you are destroying people with your position.
Kodwa wena ngaloko kuphakanyiswa kwakho ucekela abanye
phansi. You are oppressing other people using your position.
Wena ucindezela abanye abantu usebenzisa isitulo sakho.
Other people using your position.
Udlala ngabo wena ngale situlo sakho siphiwe.
Church, let us repent and start to seek the welfare of all people.
Penduke bese sibhekela abanye idingo zabo.
Plead the cause of the weak. Plead for the cause of the weak.
Khuleka ke ukuthi njengoba iviki lisaqala.
Pray for those who are in trouble.
Ukhulekele laba abasenkingeni.
Look for those who are tempted and comfort them.
Beseke ubheka laba abalingiwe bese uyabaduduza.
Help those who need help.
Usize laba abadinga usizo.
People of God, that skill, that talent, that position which God has given you.
Lolo lwazi leso sipho lokho okukhona uNkulunkulu akuphekona kusebenzise ukuthi usize abanye.
Use that talent correctly.
Sebenzisa leso sipho ngendlela engcono.
Do you remember that parable of talents?
Ngabe siyakhumbula na leso sisho ngamathalenta.
The Bible says to those who are given more.
IBhayibheli lithi kulabo abanikezwe okuningi.
More is expected of them.
Kuningi kokubhekekile kubo.
When you have been given that position that you have.
Mangabe ke unikiwe ke leso sihlalo kuso.
More is expected of you.
Kuningi lokufuthi kukhulu okubhekekile kuwe.
The parable of a talent.
Isisho ke se talente.
They were given different amount of talents.
Bebanikeziwe ke ngokuhlukana amathalenta.
And it's a shame that the one who was given few never profited it. But those who were given more, they made sure that they profit.
Laba ke bebenike okuningi benza sure ukuthi bona bathola okuningi.
People of God, if you don't profit with your position.
Bantu bakaNkulunkulu uma ngabe wena ke awuzuzi ngaloko kusihlalo
sakho. I'm not talking about profiting yourself.
I'm talking about
profiting the lives of other people.
Ukhuluma ukuthi uzuzele abanye abantu hayi wena.
That position will be taken from you.
Leso sihlalo sizosuswa sothathwa ku.
It is possible with God.
Kuyakhonakala kuNkulunkulu.
It does not matter how blessed you are.
Akukhathalisekile ukuthi ubusiseke kangakanani.
The Bible says we are blessed to be a blessing unto others.
IBhayibheli lithi sibusisekile ukuthi sibe isibusiso kwabanye.
There is no way that you are blessing other people you won't be blessed.
Angeke kwenzeke ukuthi ube isibusiso kwabanye abantu bese wena ungabusiseki.
Nobody ever removed Mordecai being a Jew in that position because why? He was seeking the welfare of other people.
Azange kagudluze uMordekhayi kuleso situlo kungani yingoba yena bekaphethe leso sihlalo ngendlela efanelekile.
Teacher, continue to look after the welfare of the young people.
Wena ke teacher qhubeka njalo ubhekelele izidingo zabantwana abancane.
Don't use your position to seek wrong favor from the children.
Ungasebenzisela ukuthi ubheke ke ifavor wrong kulabo bantwana.
Same thing goes to the police officers. You can name it to the president, everyone.
Kanjalo namaphoyisa namapresident.
How are you using your position?
Ngabe usebenzisa kanjani sakho isihlalo?
How are you using that connection that you have with those
somebodies?
Church of Jesus Christ, I'm praying that from today you start to use your influence correctly.
Umfundisi uyakhuleka kusuka namhlanje ukuthi siqale sisebenzise ngendlela efanele idulo lezi siphiwe zona.
Those of you who are children of God.
Laba bene ningabantwana bakaNkulunkulu.
God has trusted you with the position of being the child of God.
UNkulunkulu ukuthembile ke ngaleso sikhundla sokuthi ube umntwana kaNkulunkulu.
As such, go out there.
Kanjalo phuma uyele ngaphandle.
And make sure that your position profits the kingdom of heaven.
Wenzeke isiqiniseko ukuthi leso sihlalo sakho
senze inzuzo embusweni wasezulwini. By being close to you. Share with them the riches of the kingdom of heaven. Look after the lost souls. Repair these things which are broken. Use your position in a right way. Never use your Christianity to look down upon other people. I know there are Christians who say, I don't mix, I don't fellowship with sinners. How are they going to repent if you don't pull them closer to you? Seek the welfare of your people. Not your own welfare. Seeking your own welfare will only bring unhappiness in your life. It will only bring misery to your life. It will only bring distraction to your life. Look at all the people who are having a position of influence. Other people are rebelling against them and in the process kill them. Others, they are taking everything away from you. Be careful with the position that you have been given. The reason the Bible recorded Mordecai
is
because he was great among his brethren. Seeking the welfare of his people. Church of Jesus Christ, now is the time that we must bear the cross of other people.
Manje ke maKristu kuyisikhathi ukuthi thina sifanele ukuthi sithwale iphambano
zabantu. The Bible says you must bear one another's burden.
IBhayibheli ithi sithwalelane imithwalo.
It never say bear the joy of another person.
Alithi iBhayibheli thwala ukujabula komunye umuntu.
It says the burden of another person.
Lithi umthwalo womunye umuntu.
Look around and find the cross of somebody else which you must carry.
Bheka eduze kwakho ubone isiphambano somunye odinga ukusizo kuwe.
And you go to that person and offer to carry that cross for that person.
Bese uyahamba uye kulowo muntu lo uzinikele ukuthi umsize.
Bear the burden of your neighbor.
Umthwalise umakhelwane.
Bear the burden of a homeless somebody in the street.
Bese uyawuthwala umthwalo womuntu onganandawo ohlala ohlala
esitradini. Bear the burden of that person who is addicted to alcohol and drugs.
Thwala umthwalo lo muntu lo othwele ukuthi yena njalo
azokuthwala. Seek the welfare of other people, church. It must never be about you. God has blessed you as a Christian to be a blessing to other people.
But
ask your neighbor, whose cross are you carrying? I'm not talking about a stick or a plastic cross here. I'm talking about a wooden cross which is heavy. Look for that cross to carry. Stop carrying around your own cross. It will bring distraction to you. Carry the cross of another person. Yes, it worked for Joseph. Joseph, after he was elevated as a prince of Egypt, he never used his position to make his brothers to starve to death. Instead, Joseph used his position to provide food for the Israelites. He gave even shelter to those people who sold him to slavery. He never came against his brothers.
Is
that he did good to them.
That is why
the Bible says, do good to your enemies.
And
pray for those who persecute you. You see, you must also seek the good of your enemy. Carry also the cross of your enemy. If your enemy is sick, go and pray for your enemy. If your enemy is hungry, feed your enemy.
Uma ngabe isitha sakho silambile hamba uyosipha ukudla sidle.